I would like, starting with Omega, I would like you to introduce yourself, your name, what class you're in, and the favorite book you read in the whole battle of the books.
My name is Omega Lawson. I am from 5th grade Mr. Swain's class, and my favorite book was The Book Wanderers.
Bristol?
I'm Bristol, and I am in 4th grade Miss Allison's, and my favorite book was probably Lady Aurora.
I'm Audrie, and I'm in 5th grade Mr. Swain's class, and my favorite book was
The Stormkeeper.
My name is Zoey. I'm from 4th grade Miss Cunningham, and my favorite book was Save Me a Seat.
Save Me a Seat. All right, over here, Ethan.
My name is Ethan Moss. I'm from Mrs. Patch's class, Fruitdale. I'm in 5th grade, and my favorite book was The 14th Goldfish.
14th Goldfish, all right.
My name is Aiden Emanuelsson, and I'm from Miss Cunningham's class, Fruitdale Elementary. And my favorite book was probably, Book Wonders by Aiden.
I am Taylor. I'm in 5th grade and was past the class. Thank you. My favorite books were, I like Sarah Journeys West, and I also like Save Me a Seat.
My name is Olivia, Macias, and I'm from Fruitdale, 3rd grade in this class, and I didn't have a favorite book.
You didn't have a favorite book? And how about you, my friend?
Hi, my name is Gavin. I go to Fruitdale Elementary. I'm in 5th grade, and this is Guy was this class, and my favorite book was probably 14th Goldfish.
14th Goldfish. All right, great. Well, congratulations again on making the finals. We're going to do 3 rounds in the finals, okay? So we'll have... Everybody will get 24 questions, and then if there's a tiebreaker, we'll kind of go to a sudden death tiebreaker thing here in the finals. And let's see here. Again, I would ask each team to make sure they're super quiet while the other teams. And sometimes we get excited. And also, don't cheer if the other team gets the question wrong. I want really good sportsmanship, so if the other team gets the question wrong, I want to see a team going, yeah, okay? We good?
Yeah.
All right, let's rock and roll. Let me get my timer set here. Okay, so we're going to start over here with the Madrona Black Swans. And with our English book questions. You guys ready? Deep breath. Here we go. All right. In which book does someone eat 4 bowls of rice and 6 helpings of kimchi for dinner?
Guts by Raina Telgemeier.
That's correct for 5 points. In which book does a character recall it took 39 years for someone to be convicted of bombing a church?
The Clean Getaway by Nick Stone.
That's correct for 5 points. Question number 3 for the Black Swans. In which book does a character have a lawn that is filled with snails and slugs after dark?
The Unstoppable by Maria Parr.
That's incorrect. Question number 4 for the Fruitdale Panthers. In which book does a character's dad like to tell stories about Boy Scouts and Little League?
The Karen Feeney and Pet Black Hole by Michelle Cuevas.
That's incorrect. All right, Question number 5 for the Black Swans. In which book does someone remember having to split money found at a bus stop with a sibling? Okay, question number 6 for the Fruitdale Panthers. In which book does a character mispronounce Oregon? Okay, question number 7 for the Madrona Black Swans. In which book do family members each list 3 things from the day that they are grateful for?
Stay by Bobby Pyron.
That's correct for 5 points. Question number 8 for the Fruitdale Panthers. In which book does a character want to serve but finds out they do not weigh enough to join the army?
Some Writer, the story of E.B. White by Melissa Sweet.
That's correct for 5 points. All right, we're going to move on to the content questions. In the content questions, I will read the question. I will read the title of the book. I will ask the question. If it's a two-part question, I will tell you that before the question. Also, it's a two-part question. You have to get both parts to get the full 5 points. If you get one part, you'll get 3 points. But I'll let you know if it's a two-part question. Okay? You ready?
Mm-hmm.
All right, here we go. Question number 1 for the Madrona Black Swans. The title of the book is Sarah Journeys West. The question is, when Sarah was a baby, what did her granny make for her?
A quilted blanket.
That is correct for 5 points. Question number 2 for Fruitdale Panthers. Title is Astrid the Unstoppable. Question is, what is the name of the smaller mountain right behind Goonball's farm?
More peak?
That is incorrect. The correct answer is the nape.
The nape?
Oh, the nape.
The nape. Oh, yeah, the nape.
All right, question number 3 for the Madrona Black Swans. The title of the book is Stay. The question is, what percentage of brownie sales does the Firefly Girl Troop get to keep? That is incorrect. The correct answer is 40%. All right, question number four. Fruitdale. The title of the book is I Can Make This Promise. The question is, what is the last name of Edie's orthodontist? That is incorrect. I apologize. Ashworth is the correct answer.
Doctor.
All right. The title of the book is Guts. Question is, when Raina starts fifth grade, what grade does her sister begin?
Kindergarten.
That's correct for 5 points. All right. Question number six for Fruitdale Panthers. The title of the book is The Harlem Charade. Around what time did Elvin's grandfather go for his nightly walk on the night of the attack?
11 to 12.
Midnight.
It wasn't midnight.
No,
I think it was
11.
Yeah,
so
it was
11. Yeah. 11? That is correct.
Yes.
For 5 points.
At least we're still tired. Isn't it?
Well, we said midnight.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. All right, question number seven. For the Madrona Black Swans, the title of the book is The 14th Goldfish. And the question is, what is the exact four-word name for the dish Melvin always orders at the Chinese restaurant?
Goo goo fine. Goo
goo. No. Goo goo
gai fan. That is correct for 5 points. Question number eight for the Fruitdale Panthers. The title of the book is Some Rider, the story of Amy White. The question is, what is the full name of the illustrator chosen for Stuart Little? Scorekeeper, what do we have?
For a subtotal for the Black Swans, we have 25 overall. Mm-hmm. And for the overall for the Panthers, we have 15.
All right, I agree. Coaches, you want to check in with the team?
It's good.
We have asked them. They're still alive.
Thank you. I'm so excited.
I apologize.
Sorry, it's probably Zoey and Lawson.
And Zoey, what school do you go to?
Madrona.
Good, because you're on the Madrona team. So that works out. And what was your favorite book?
Mine was probably The Book Wanderers.
The Book Wanderers. And I apologize. I missed you.
Oh, it's fine. It's probably because I was wearing my hoodie.
You probably. So we have two new participants. Same format. We're going to start with the English book questions, and then we'll move on to the content questions. All right. Same captains?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, here we go. Question number one. Oh, give me a second here. Alright, question number one for the Madrona Black Swans. In which book does a character have a reddish brown box made of rosewood?
Clean Getaway by Nick Stone.
That is correct. With 5 points. Question number two for the Fruitdale Panthers. In which book do two family members have the same deep, deep sea blue eyes? Deep, deep sea blue eyes.
Storky was over my Catherine Doyle.
Yeah. I'm sure that's incorrect.
Is it
before?
I don't
All right, question number three for the Madrona Black Swans. In which book does someone read a book where a character has two pets named Schwanley and Bearley?
Seconds? The Book Wanderers by Anna James.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. Okay, Fruitdale Panthers, question number four. In which book do characters walk around Alphabet City, also known as the East Village?
Some Places More Than Others by Nantucket Harper.
That is correct for 3 points.
Okay. It's not zero.
Okay, question number five for the Madrona Black Swans. In which book is a big fireplace filled with fresh flowers during the summer?
Ask for the Unstoppable by Maria Carr.
Sorry, that is incorrect. Question number six for the Fruitdale Panthers. In which book do two dogs jump into a swimming pool even though it's against the rules?
Lydia Out Loud by Angela Cervantes.
That is correct for 5 points. Okay, question number seven for the Madrona Black Swans. In which book does someone's older brother have the nickname Bun because he could wiggle his nose like a bunny?
Ready Out Loud by Angela Cervantes.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. Okay, question number 8 for the Fruitdale of the Black Panthers. In which book does a character say, a woman can do anything a man can do?
Sarah Journeys West and Oregon Survival Trail by Nikki Shannon Smith.
That's correct for 5 points?
Yes!
Alright, so we're going to move on to our content questions. I'll start with Madrona. The title of the book is Stay. This is a two-part question. Uh-huh. Name two of the states that have a Hartwell man.
One of them.
Kentucky and Idaho.
That's correct for 3 points. Georgia and Texas. Okay, the title of the book is Guts. And the question is, what one word does Raina think to herself after Mr. Abrams calls her up for her presentation? What is the name of the container in which Ravi brings his school lunch?
Tiffin box.
That's correct. For 5 points. Number 4 for the Fruitdale Panthers. The title is Sarah Journeys West. And the question is, name an item that gets left behind in order to make the wagons move faster as winter approaches.
No.
Is
it food?
No.
No.
Five seconds.
A wooden box?
That is incorrect. Trunks, tools, farming equipment.
Oh, my.
All right, question number 5 for the Madrona Black Swans. The title of the book is The Care and Feeding of a Pet Black Hole. And the question is, what color is Stella's clothing when she drops off the black hole at NASA in the last chapter?
black with stars.
That is correct for 5 points.
Yes.
All right, question number 6 for the Fruitdale Panthers. The title of the book is Some Rider, the story of Edie White. And the question is, what is the name of the dog featured in A True Dog Story for which Elwin wins a gold badge? Five seconds.
Say something.
Lucky. That's incorrect. The picture was Beppo.
And
the All right, question number 7 for Madrona Black Swans. The title of the book is Some Places More Than Others. And the question is, Amara's dad promises they will return to New York one day to do what activity?
Skate.
So is it correct? Correct answer is see a Broadway play. All right. Fruitdale Black Panthers. The title of the book is The Stormkeeper's Island. And the question is, what did Winnie wish for on her husband's birthday that went into a special memory candle? So our score that round was?
For Madrona, we have 18, and for Fruitdale, we have 13.
That's correct. So that means our score after 2 rounds, if I'm doing my math correctly, 43 for Madrona, and 28 for Fruitdale. Everybody ready? You ready for the final round, the third and final round? All right, here we go. Guys are doing great. Super impressed. There we go. First question. Question number 1. Madrona Black Swans. This is an English book question. We're going to start with those. In which book does a character wonder why poets can't just tell you directly what their poems mean?
Charade by Natasha
Tarpey. That is correct for 5 points. Question number 2 for the Fruitdale Panthers. In which book? The title of the book is Guts. Question is, Raina's doctor says that Raina has an upset stomach with no discernible cause. What is the name of the illness the doctor diagnoses?
Irritated bowel syndrome.
That's correct for 5 points. The title of the book is The Stormkeeper's Island. Question is, what is the full name of the boy who died in the sea cave 30 years before Theon came to the island? Five seconds. Time?
Adam Smith.
So that is incorrect. Correct answer was Albert King. All right, the title of the book is Some Rider, the story of E.B. White. Question is, what is the title of the book by William Strunk, Jr., that Andy helped to revive? Seconds. Time?
Pass.
Okay. Correct answer was Elements of Style. All right. Question number 4 for the Fruitdale Panthers. The title of the book is I Can Make This Promise. And the question is, what 3 exact words does Roger say to Edie that she has never been told before? Five seconds.
Need any help?
Sorry, that's incorrect. Correct answer is you look native. All right, question number 5 for the Madrona Black Swans. The title of the book is The 14th Goldfish. And the question is, what type of flowers does Ben bring Melissa before their date?
Daffodils.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. Correct answer is carnations. Question number 6 for the Fruitdale Panthers. The title of the book is The Harlem Charade. And the question is, what is the full 3-part name of the curator emeritus and board chairwoman of the Studio Museum in Harlem? Five seconds.
Just say something.
Time?
Pass.
Okay. It was Verda May Sneed. Alright, the last question for the Madrona Black Swans. The title of the book is The Book Wanderers. And the question is, what is the exact 5-word motto of the underlibrary as translated into English by Tilly's granddad? 5 seconds. 10.
Reading is just as wandering.
Sorry, that is incorrect. To read is to wander.
Oh my goodness.
Close. Final question for the Fruitdale Penguins. The title of the book is Lowriders in Space. And the question is, what is the exact three-word motto of lowriders everywhere?
Low and slow.
Yeah. Low and slow. That is correct. For 5 points.
Low and slow.
All right. What do we have?
Our overall total for Madrona is 25, and for Fruitdale it is also 25.
All right. So I think that brings our total up. Let me check my math here. It's Fruitdale with 53 points, and Madrona with 68. Yeah. Congratulations to everybody. You guys did a great job. I'm super impressed.
I have ribbons for second place and first place.